welcome to the award ceremony and finale dinner of the 7th Annual NASA Robotic Mining Competition. Am I too loud? My name is Kurt Lloyd. It's been my pleasure to be your MC this week. And I would like to start off by showing you a really great video that the public affairs folks and education folks in the NASA office have prepared for you. They've gone around and taken video all week long. Now, watch what they've come up with. Has presented college students with the challenge of mining regolith, just as if they were on another planet. And every year the competition has been an unqualified success. Would you agree? Yeah! This year we had 45 teams from across the US with over 700 students and faculty in attendance. NASA recognizes that while the robots only compete for 1 week, the actual work continues year-round. Let's give all these teams a big round of applause for their accomplishments. Thank you to all of the returning teams for your continued support, and we hope that the new teams will come back and participate again. We commend you all for your hard work and dedication to promoting space activities, STEM, and exploration. Now, if you receive an award tonight, please come down in front of this backdrop to collect your plaque, and you're going to get your photo taken right here as a team in front of this backdrop. Our first speaker became an astronaut in 1986. Flying 4 space shuttle missions, including the very first International Space Station assembly mission in 1998. Today, he is the center director of KSC. Please welcome Mr. Robert Cabana.
You guys having fun? This is one of the most fun weeks at the Kennedy Space Center. I look forward to it every year. This is our 7th annual competition. And I feed off your enthusiasm. I firmly believe you gotta hang with young people if you wanna stay young. And you guys, you're more awesome than some of the engineers I got working for me. I wanna hire some of you. And I think we are. So, I think regardless of how you did in the competition, everybody learned something while they were here. Now think about what it took to design and build your robot, to test it, to transport it here to the Kennedy Space Center, and to operate in the regolith. and actually accomplish what you set out to do. You know how challenging that was and how you got to work together as a team. You got to have diversity on your team. You got to listen to everybody. You got to work together as one, and you got to overcome problems. Now imagine sticking that rover on top of an Atlas V, launching it on a 9-month trip to Mars, going through those how many ever seconds of terror as a sky crane lowers it down to the ground, and have all those time delays, you know, 15 to 17 minute time delays, and have it work. Now, think about doing that with your robot. Think of the magnitude of the difference. You just had to ship it down to KSC, you know? and there were no time delays. But, you know, that's what we're doing. Robots are the precursors to humans, to exploration, to learning as much as we possibly can before we send humans to Mars. And here at the Kennedy Space Center, you know, I hope that you got to see a little bit about what was going on. But, you know, if you look out there to Launch Pad B, where those lightning protection towers are, and that new clean pad, they're installing the fire brick in it now, you know, it's totally refurbished. Just look at that. Take a look at that pad before you leave, because I want you to go home and say, we're going to Mars from that pad with humans, all right? That's what we're doing here at the Kennedy Space Center. Every time I'm in here, I look at this awesome Saturn V rocket, and I think about what we accomplished going to the moon, right? And now, we are putting the infrastructure in place here at Kennedy Space Center that's going to allow us to go to Mars with humans, and that is going to be really special. I'm not going to talk about all the neat stuff we're doing in that regard, but I got to throw in a couple of plugs for the rest of my KSC team. You know, we got the commercial crew program here. Hopefully we're going to get a couple of test flights in 2017 with Boeing and SpaceX, preparing to send crews to the International Space Station in 2018 on a U.S. rocket instead of having to rely on our Russian partners. That's going to be awesome. Our launch services program procures all the expendable vehicles for NASA's science missions. We're getting ready to launch OSIRIS-REx this fall on an Atlas V. That's going to be amazing. And then, you know, I got my ISS science team getting experiments like veggie up to the International Space Station so astronauts can actually eat real food, you know, like that nice salad that we had tonight, as opposed to freeze-dried and thermally stabilized food, which isn't all that bad. I'd much rather do that than go to a meeting. I'm ready to go back to space. If it'll get me out of a meeting, I was kind of thinking, you know, the first test flight on Orion, you know, if I could hide away. But, you know, they talk about all that radiation going to Mars. What the heck? I'm old. I can take it. And then, you know, we're doing some awesome science here at KSC. It's only like 3% of our portfolio, but you guys saw my science guys firsthand. All that work, all the team working over there with you in the regolith, going through all the stuff that they do. KSC is known for in-situ resource utilization. We want to be able to go to Mars, to wherever, and utilize the resources that are there to actually keep humans alive, get the propellant, not have to take so much stuff with us, and actually use the resources of the planet. And how are we going to do that? We're going to do it through robotic mining when we get there. And that's why what you guys are doing is important. We actually learn from you, and it's really neat to see, even the first time teams that come, the complexity of the robots, and now seeing swarms of robots, more than one out there in the bin, it's awesome. So you guys, I have no doubt at all, in the future of our country, we are going to continue to do amazing things because we got folks like you. So study hard, do well, and come back and be part of this amazing team. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Cabana. After that video, there are some pretty impressive statistics I forgot to mention. We were live streaming this event this week, and while we were live streaming this week, we had 4,435 unique computers that were watching that stream. Not all simultaneously, but that is a lot of people. They were from all over the world. Over 70 countries were watching the stream. All 50 states, including plus Washington, D.C. So the word is getting out there. People are seeing this competition, not just the people that are here on site. Now, in order to present the Innovation Award, please welcome the head judge, your head judge, Mr. Rob Mueller.
You know what this is?
Innovation Award.
It's a small robot made, welded from race car parts. And it was made by a technician that was helping you all week in the bot shop. You probably met him. And he was inspired by your robots, and he made this and he donated it to this competition. So it was a very special prize. This is the Innovation Award. It's the Judges Innovation Award. It's given every year to the team that does something different. You don't have to win to get this award. You just have to try something different and take a risk. That's what this award is all about. We had two honorable mentions. There's only one award, but there was many good teams. And the first honorable mention goes to John Brown University. For the good use of autonomy. Excellent autonomy concept. Second honorable mention goes to the University of Virginia for their auger-based excavator. Before I announce the winner of this Judges Innovation Award, I would just like to explain to you, why do we dig? Why do we dig? I'm sure you know, but you may not know the details. When we go to Mars, the astronauts will not be able to come home until the Mars Ascent Vehicle, the MAV, the MAV, is fueled. We send it there empty, and we have to fill it with propellants, methane and oxygen, before it can come home. We make those propellants on Mars through resources from the atmosphere, which is 95.5% carbon dioxide, and water, which is found in the regolith. So we're missing a technology. The technology is acquiring the water in the regolith. To get the water in the regolith, you have to dig, excavate. And that's what you're doing. And we're watching you so we can see if you come up with any new concepts or new ideas on how to dig regolith on Mars. There's lots of water on Mars, but it's not on the surface anymore. It's below the surface in the regolith. So I just wanted to make that point to you that the reason we dig is so we can find water on Mars. And there's plenty of data that's coming out. In fact, we're working on a mission for 2022 now, which will go look for that water from orbit with special sensors. So that's why we dig. So let's get back to the Innovation Award. The winner of the Judges Innovation Award 2016 is the University of Utah. They had a very innovative design where they were able to shift the mass of their excavator so it wouldn't tip over. We've never seen anything like that, so we'd like to present this award to them.
And now, to present the Cervi Regolith Mechanics Innovation Award, please welcome UCF Planetary Scientist, Dr. Phil Metzger.
Thank you. So I'm a part of the Solar System Exploration Virtual Institute, or SERVI. And I'd like to also point out Joe Bonafra. He's the lead for innovation and partnerships in SERVI, one of the organizers of the SERVI network. So it's a virtual institute that includes 8 nodes around the nation. One of those nodes is at the University of Central Florida. It's centered there, and it's called CLASS, the Center for Lunar and Asteroid Surface Science. Now, what we do at SERVI is we sponsor research and organize research to pave the way for exploration in the solar system, because these other worlds out there are different than Earth, and we need to understand the environment. We need to understand the way the soil behaves, different gravity, different type of weathering in the soil, the ices, the atmosphere, and there are a lot of things that happen that we don't anticipate. So we're doing research to understand the solar system. And I think this is very important, because I'm totally convinced this is the century that humanity will get beyond the limits of this planet. Robotics is growing at such a high rate right now that certainly within a century, we're going to have the ability to do mining and manufacturing. And once we establish supply chains off the Earth, then settling space will become inevitable. And that's why competitions like this are so important, because you're leading the way, developing the technologies to get us beyond the limits of our planet. So for this award, we are looking for innovation in working with the granular materials, the regolith, specifically looking at the mechanics of regolith and schools that have found innovative ways to manage it in order to do their mining operations. The judges proposed a number of different schools. We discussed them and we voted on them. And after the vote, the winner of this year's Regolith Mechanics Innovation Award goes to the Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. And while they're coming up, I would like to say they had an innovative wheel design that we haven't seen before, and maybe you can speak with them later if you'd like to get details.
Congratulations. And now to present the Autonomy Award, please welcome Eric Reiners, Manager of Automation Systems Research and Advanced Engineering at Caterpillar Incorporated.
All right, thank you. So I'm here to do the Autonomy Award. And I'd like to start with the fact that autonomy is hard, right? And we at Caterpillar know it's hard, because we're doing it every day. How many of you had a chance to see the semi-autonomous tractor demonstration or drive the tractor in Tucson, Arizona this year? Great. So it's hard, and Caterpillar and the judges here are very impressed and inspired to see what you all are able to do here. And the fact that many of you are actually using graduate level concepts and actually implementing those as undergraduates is very impressive to see. So this year we had about 25% of the teams competing actually contemplated autonomy, architected autonomy, and at least had some aspect of that as part of their robots. We saw the use of computer vision, LiDAR, the ability to fuse computer vision and LiDAR data for positioning, as well as ranging radio techniques for positioning as inputs to autonomy. And we had 5 teams that actually attempted autonomy in their runs. And two of those teams were successful in achieving points in the autonomy scoring. And so second place for the autonomy award this year goes to South Dakota School of Mines and Technology.
Come on up for a photo.
And first place and returning winners from last year is the University of Alabama.
Computer engineer Philip Michael to present the Communication Award.
Hi, I'm Philip Michael. I was one of the communication editors this year. This week we've been monitoring the spectrum, the network. We've been performing checkouts, trying to do everything we can to make this competition as fair and as fun as possible. A quick question that I'd like to ask. How many people, teams here, had communication issues this year? This year compared to previous years, we've been made it more difficult on you. Only give you 5 minutes instead of time versus seven. And from what we've seen, everyone steps up to the challenge really, really well. The Effective Use of Communication Power Award was created to show the importance conserving communication and designing your robot. For deep space missions, communication links are the lifeline back to Earth, delivering valuable data, often consuming considerable power and weight. Even though you're designing robots for here on Earth, the designs that you create could one day be used to go to the moon, which would experience a communication delay of about a second, or to Mars, where the delay may be anywhere from 5 minutes to 20 minutes. As the delays get longer, the importance of automation also increases and helps reduce bandwidth. For the efficient use of communication power world, we looked at the data transfer in proportion to the regolith collected. The teams with the most efficient use of power or use of communication was the University of Akron. Second while using two cameras.
That's a big team.
They sent their own camera to foster commands.
That's amazing.
That's some young
resolution right there.
It's two pixels.
They're super good. It's like crazy. I'd actually go. But I think I'll go. Yeah, I talked to
them a lot. Today was the one of the and the football.
I mean, it's happy. She wasn't like, hey, Zeller, why don't you? Because, like, Mark looks like a good man.
Congratulations. And now, please welcome Jeanette Stecklin, the NASA Robotic Mining Competition Lead Systems Engineering Judge, who will present the Systems Engineering Paper Award.
Papers. 27 of those papers advanced to round one, and 6 of those papers advanced to round two. And I will announce the top 3. For the third place winner, the judges had this to say. The entire paper represents a thoughtful and thorough systems engineering approach to the project, starting with the previous year project lessons learned in the 2015 closeout review. Excellent discussion of the design philosophy and how it affects the design process. Excellent use of the review entrance criteria to drive the work in the phases leading up to the reviews. The team showed the iterative management of their resource budget and used the results to improve the design, which resulted in more margin as the design progressed. And the third place winner is the University of Illinois at Chicago. Then did research and performed trade studies to determine the changes they would make. And the second place winner is Oakton Community College. Thank you. Using N-squared diagrams and schematics. The team considered manufacturing and implementation throughout the design process. And the winner of the System Engineering Paper Award is the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign.
Project Manager, who will present the Outreach Project Report Award and the Social Media and Public Engagement Award. Rich Jonabek.
Good evening. How are you guys doing tonight? One more time, give it up. Oh yeah, that's so good. Alrighty, so the Outreach Award is for you guys going into local communities, into the Boys Clubs, Girl Club, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, Little Leagues, your schools. Some of you took on teams throughout the year, ended up with different challenges, robotic hands, egg drops, all those things to turn those minds on, because you never know what's that one thing that you do or say that will turn somebody onto a STEM career in the future. Somebody that reached out to you in the past that got to you where you are today. So, the winning team will receive a $500 team scholarship, a team plaque, and really great certificates. And I mean, really, how cool is a certificate with the NASA logo on it, huh?
Yeah! Yeah.
All right, so the third place winner is a great underdog, and that's not really the great term, but I love these guys. The third place winner is Oakton Community College. Okay, so The second place winner is, ready? Iowa State University. Come on down. And the winner of the RMC 2016 Outreach Project Report Award is the University of North Dakota. Come on down. Next award is the Social Media and Public Engagement Award, and this is taking, it's an optional category, it's not required. We're asking you social media to engage the public and interact with NASA and the RMC teams to promote STEM activities through the K-12 community, especially in robotics. So, let's start up with the third place winner is the University of Alabama. The second place winner for the Social Media and Public Engagement Award, Oakton Community College. Social Media and Public Engagement Award. Iowa State University, come on down.
Maybe you can
Congratulations, teams. Social media and public engagement, a very important part of this competition. And now, please welcome Don Edwards from Caterpillar Incorporated, who will present the slide presentation and demonstration award. Don.
So the slide presentation and demonstration award is also an optional category, but I guess the idea I'd like to leave you with, you guys. Aside from some noise, is that you guys are working, as Eric said, it's hard. It's getting increasingly hard. You're working with teams all over the world. Communication is going to become an essential skill for anybody graduating in a technical field. You go into a small company, trying to sell your ideas to venture capitalists, being a company like Caterpillar trying to work the worldwide team. So we saw some outstanding presentations. You were asked to look at the process that you used in developing your robots. You were asked to demonstrate the capability of your robots. Everybody did an outstanding job. We looked at content. We looked at the technical merit. And we looked at how well you demonstrated that. And in the final analysis, we had three very good contenders. The third place team was Colorado School of Mines. University of North Dakota. And the first place team, 2016 Presentation and Demonstration Award, University of Alabama.
Congratulations. those demonstration and slideshow experiences are going to come in handy later in life in the workplace. All right, it's my pleasure to announce the On-Site Mining Award. The On-Site Mining Award showcases what the teams and the robots can do. Each team was given the task of mining and depositing a minimum of 10 kilograms of BP1 and IC regolith during each of their two competition attempts. Teams with the three highest points averaged over both attempts earn the top three mining awards. First place, they get 25 points and a $3,000 team scholarship. Second place, 20 points and a $2,000 team scholarship. Third place, 15 points and a $1,000 team scholarship. Teams not placing first, second, or third will receive 1 point per kilogram mined and deposited, up to 10 points maximum. In third place, we have Oakden Robotics from Oakden Community College. Rob Mueller, come on down. Get the photo with them, please. We'll have to mail you the plaque after we get it engraved. Sorry about that. And now, in second place, Moon Pie from the Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. And in first place for the On-Site Mining Award, we have Alabama Astrobotics from the University of Alabama. Please welcome your head judge to the stage, Mr. Rob Mueller.
See, I didn't know, because it's a big surprise until the award ceremony. This year's grand prize winner, with a score of 90.45 out of 100 possible points, is, drumroll,
Congratulations. All right, I hope everybody had a great time, and I hope everybody will come back next time. That will conclude the RMC Award Ceremony for this year. Thank you again, all teams, for a great competition. We hope to see you again next year. Goodbye.